Coming up next on Jewish Voice.
First time I'm ever in the White House, I'm sitting next to him. I'm going, who's sitting here? The president is. We're on national TV, and all my ex-crack friends are going, what is this crack addict doing on TV next to the president? He always told us that, you know, Jesus is real, because this is impossible.
Can God change your life in the next 30 minutes? I believe you're watching right now because God has something special for you. Join me for Jewish Voice, and you'll discover how Bible prophecy is coming to pass before our very eyes, and why you need to stand with Israel. You can play a role in God's end time plan. Find out how on Jewish Voice. Shalom and welcome to Jewish Voice, and thank you for joining me today. I'm Jonathan Bernis, and I'm joined by someone who I'm sure all of you will recognize right away. You probably know him best from his commercials for MyPillow, but you may not know that he's also a Christian living out his faith every day, just like you and I. Mike, we're so glad to have you at Jewish Voice. Welcome.
I'm honored to be here.
I want to say my wife and I are fans. We have landed on the blue label.
Right pillow. On. You're looking yeah. good. I knew you would.
Sleeping well, but yeah. we really appreciate you. You have a great story. I want to begin by this. There's so many people watching right now that are so discouraged. Some are in despair. We get letters all the time. They don't know what's ahead. They don't know what tomorrow brings. Right. You have an answer for them.
Well, you know, I've said before, people don't look, you know, for God. They don't look to God. They don't look for, you know, for until something bad happens or until things are bad. I was with a guy and he's last year, and he said, you know, it would take the Great Depression to bring people back to God. And I said, no, I said, we have something better than the Great Depression. They had God, they were praying for, you know, food and shelter. Well, now we have addiction, and then we have this pandemic. We have all these things that happen. You know, all these things is a gateway for hope. And where's that hope? The hope is Jesus. So it's, I look at it as an opportunity. You know, we have an opportunity in history for the greatest revival ever.
Amen.
You know, I absolutely
Amen.
Believe that.
We sure do. Well, let me just wind back to your story. Mm-hmm. You have an amazing story. I really can relate to it. I'll tell you some specifics later. I'll leave right. it to you, but just give us a thumbnail sketch of your story.
Yeah,
God really had a call on your life, and you really hit bottom.
Absolutely. Well, you know, it's my story goes back to when I was a kid, and you know, at 7 years old, my parents divorced, and back when divorces weren't common, and I was put into a new school, and I was the only kid from a broken family. And I believe that, you know, addictions and things, if you don't have the foundation of God early on, or at least some seeds planted, they manifest into addictions where you get false courage. I had a thing where I either didn't talk to people, or I would show off. I climbed out of a moving bus window and say, hey, watch me do this, and jumped, you know. And just things, I had all kinds of things happen to me. But at our five-year reunion, class reunion, this is in my book, we got there, and all of them had graduated from college. They were, you know, their careers were all started. I had dropped out of college in the first quarter, and they're all talking about these things. They had started families, and I was just hurting inside. Well, I started telling about what I had done. I owed the mafia money for football bets. They came to break my arms. I had fell asleep on a motorcycle, crashed it, going skydiving, and my parachute didn't open all in the same day. So you had these things, and they took over the reunion. Well, I got home that night and laying in bed, and I had this deep sadness. I wanted what they had, you know. I wanted what they had, this what I considered that's where my happiness would be. And I was handed that on it was the perfect marriage, and we raised a family. But before that, I got introduced to cocaine, and it was a very functioning addict. Then I could talk to people. I didn't have it was a false courage. You had these, you know, these pains that block pain. It was just, you know, basically a functioning addict. I think people get into a fallacy where, oh, an addict is someone in the streets homeless. No, it doesn't matter how many forks you eat with, whether it's zero to four forks, everybody can be affected by addiction.
That's amazing. So you could go on with your life and still be addicted to drugs, and you were able to mask it.
Yeah, absolutely. And say, you know, any kind of addiction, there's functioning addicts across the board. And it goes back to wounds and trauma, fatherless, and, you know, the fatherless, and not having, you know, a father figure, even if a father's there, but he's really not there, you know, I mean, and I think so many things happen in childhood, and then, but trauma too. You have our veterans that get traumatized, and so that's what manifests to addictions. And if you don't have, that's why secular treatment. You go into secular treatment. That's why they don't work.
Mike, did you think you were fine through this? Like, did you learned how to maintain a lifestyle
right.
with drug addiction? Mm-hmm. Did you have this nagging feeling something's really wrong? I've got to deal with. Or were you this was okay?
I would tell my friends, I knew I had a bigger calling, and I would tell my friends, we'd be out doing drugs, drinking or whatever after the bars would close, and I'd be telling them about revelation I read in the Bible when I was in jail, you know, and they would quit and find Jesus, and I'm going, what am I saying? I'm losing friends, you know? And it got to be, you know, what really changed then in the early 2000s, I got into crack cocaine. You know, it was very hard to function on crack cocaine. It's a different drug than cocaine.
Yeah, that's where you cross the line.
Yeah,
Mike, so let me, I've got to go back to this because this is so key. You knew that God had a call on your life.
Absolutely.
And you were pushing away from that. You were pushing God back.
And you know, when it got into crack cocaine, at about the same time I invented my pillow in the early 2000, 2004, well, then you had these two parallel tracks, you know. I was very good at, you know, as good as I could be at hiding the addiction, but it's very hard. But one thing, and then over here, I had a parallel track of my pillow going on. But through all this, I ended up getting a divorce of 20 years, 20-year marriage. I had so much betrayal happen. And then I even had drug dealers do it in 2008, do an intervention. I had been up for days, and they do an intervention. They go, if you you need to... I come out of the room. I was downtown Minneapolis. I come out. I go, what are you guys doing here? There's all three of them, these biggest dealers. And I go. They go, you've been up for days, and you're going to bed, or we're not selling you anymore.
They conspired against. By the way, this is amazing. Right. I heard this. They conspired against you.
It was like
not to sell you drugs.
Right. It was like an intervention. I went down to the streets of Minneapolis at 2:30 in the morning. I come back upstairs, and the last one sitting there, he had woke back up, and he goes. Mike, you've been telling us for years. I was all upset. He goes, you've been telling us for years that this my pillow is just a platform for God, and you're going to quit all your addictions and come back and help us someday, and we're not going to let you die on us. And he said, give me your phone, and he took a picture. That's what's on the cover of my book, where you have the changes from that day that they did that intervention till now.
Yeah, speaking of the book, we want to get this into people's hands this week. What are the odds? It's a great question. Why do you call it
what are the odds? From crack addict to CEO. And the reason, what are the odds, though, comes from in my life, you know, I had if you see in anybody's life, you have a one in a million, or something else happens, a one in a billion, or let's say something happens you can't even explain. When do you add them together and it becomes a miracle? And you say, that's a miracle. And for me, I use mathematics to keep, you know, in my faith, you're going, okay, this God's real because this couldn't have happened. So you use mathematics to show that God is real.
Yeah.
And throughout my book, you know, and you get there too, you know, you're looking at, it's not just, by the way, the book's PG-13. There's no swear words in there. I want everybody to know that. I mean, people go, oh, a crack addict wrote it. It's going
to
be.
But you've come to the clear conclusion, it's a miracle.
Yeah, it really is a miracle. And it's a story of hope. I believe it's going to help millions of people. Bring them to, you know, it's a story of hope. And everybody knows, you know, for me to come from a crack addict to where I am now, I mean, that's impossible. Let's just face it. It's impossible.
The odds are too great. Many of you that are watching need hope. I can't think of a better thing to get into your hands. Or maybe it's a loved one. Maybe it's a grandchild, a brother, a sister, a friend. What are the odds? This is a story of hope. And I really want to get into your hands today. For your support, we want to get this out to you as our way of saying thank you and sowing into your life. We also have a beautiful keychain, Pray for the Peace of Jerusalem. We really encourage you in every program. You know, it says they will prosper that love thee. So if you want to prosper, Mike, pray for the peace of Jerusalem.
Absolutely.
And I want to encourage you to become a monthly Shalom partner. You talk about hope. There are Jewish people living in remote areas of the world, Holocaust survivors that we're reaching out to. We're, through your help, providing dentures to Holocaust survivors that aren't able to eat meat. We're clean water to Jewish communities and their neighbors in Ethiopia and Zimbabwe, and they've been hit by COVID. So I want to encourage you, pick up the phone, call now, become a Shalom partner. We have a beautiful Afghan throw we'll also send you as our way of saying thank you. You'll keep warm over the winter months. But this is a critical time. As Mike said, this is the greatest opportunity in history, perhaps, to get the gospel out. There's going to be a great revival.
Absolutely. The biggest revival ever. I truly believe that. This is the opportunity. It starts with Israel.
I do, too. So now, don't wait till tomorrow. Pick up the phone, call, get involved, become a Shalom partner. We'll get Mike's book right out to you with the Afghan throw and the Pray for the Peace of Jerusalem keychain. Don't wait. Now is your time.
Jonathan's guest today, Mike Lindell, is proof of God's faithfulness and commitment to restoration. It's a true story of the Lord's redemptive power. What Are the Odds is Mike Lindell's personal testimony of his journey from being a self-destructive crack addict to now being the CEO of a very successful company in the United States. This book will inspire you and show you the power of the gospel. Mike's autobiography, What Are the Odds, is available today for your one-time gift of $40. And we will include this Stand with Israel keychain as a reminder that your gift is supporting Jewish Voice outreaches around the world. Don't miss this opportunity to receive both of these resources as you support Jewish Voice Ministries with a one-time gift today of $40 or more. Jonathan is encouraging you to join him as a new monthly Shalom partner today. Your continued monthly gifts are vital in providing the ongoing support so desperately needed in these communities. As you make an ongoing commitment and become a new monthly Shalom partner with a gift of just $30 today, you'll not only receive What Are the Odds and the Stand with Israel keychain, but Jonathan will also send you this beautifully woven peace blessing Afghan throw, declaring the words of Psalm 122, "Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May those who love you be at peace. May there be shalom within your walls." Again, you will receive these resources for your generous support of just $30 a month. Your gift today can change a life, providing the opportunity to not only meet their physical needs, but also the chance to share the love of Jesus in a very real and personal way. Call our 800 number now and let our representative know what level of giving you would like to participate in. If you prefer, you can always choose to give online at jewishvoice.tv, or you can simply text JVMI to 474747. You can also donate by mailing your gift to the address on the screen. If you are already a Shalom partner, please call to receive a special offer just for you. Thank you for your generous support of Jewish Voice and for making a difference in so many lives through your sacrifice. Now, let's rejoin Jonathan and Mike Lindell.
Welcome back. Hey, before Mike and I continue our conversation, I just want to take a moment to say thank you. Thank you for supporting Jewish Voice, and especially for those of you who are monthly Shalom partners. You're truly making a difference in the lives of so many people, Jewish people and their neighbors that are in desperate need, Holocaust survivors. We could not do this without you. It would be impossible. So thank you. Mike, I want to jump for a minute. We want to come back to your testimony, but you're a lover of Israel. I saw a picture of you being baptized in the Jordan by my good friend, Jonathan Kahn. Mm-hmm. Sid is also a close friend, Sid Roth.
I went over there with him too, both of them.
Both of them told me. Where did that come from? Why are you a lover of Israel?
Well, I went there the first time was on a trip in the fall of 2015, and I'd never been there before. And I get over there, and for me, first and foremost, I felt it was a feeling I've never had ever, and it was all this. You know, I told you before that I would always use these little miracles in my own life that Jesus and God exists. Well, you get over to Israel and you have physical proof. I mean, I'm looking at these Dead Sea Scrolls and I'm looking at this and here's where Jesus walked. And it's just, it became so real to me. I think everyone, you know, you get to the wall and you're praying on there where millions have prayed. And, and I especially had an experience on the Sea of Galilee, you know, and been, and just these, that, kind of planted, you know, led up to me getting to completely surrender, you know, to do a complete surrender, which wasn't until February 18, 2017. But that's one of the pieces that I needed to physically be over there.
The realization this can't be, the odds are too great. This
is
truly a miracle.
Yeah, the odds are too great.
You know, Mark Twain reached the same conclusion.
Right, yeah.
He came back from Israel and said, the miracle of Israel and the survival of the Jewish people is against all odds.
Yeah, absolutely.
There's a God.
And then if you really, you know, you start, you know, reading it from the Bible, those who bless Israel are blessed. Those who curse it are cursed. I mean, you know, I myself do just my bit, you know, myself, my business. We planted olive trees over at the Golan Heights and the Mount of Olives. And I, you know, everything I bless Israel, I do get blessed with my company and myself. And that's not, I do it because I know I'm supposed to do it, but I also, you know, it's true. I do get blessed because of it.
I couldn't agree with you more.
And so, this is end time stuff, too. Israel, this is end times. I mean, we have to get behind Israel. And what a great president we had that did more for Israel than any president ever, is my mind, you know.
They adore Donald Trump.
Absolutely.
They've named train stations, streets. I mean, look at what he did after 25 years of postponing the move to Jerusalem of our embassy.
Right.
He finally had the guts, and I believe it was a God thing.
Oh yeah.
And he moved that embassy, recognized the Golan Heights, the West Bank. Mm-hmm. He is a beloved man in Israel.
Absolutely.
And I don't know if he's following Bible prophecy intentionally, but he's sure getting it right. He's sure been getting it right.
Well, you can even look at that. I mean, you know, everyone knows God chose Donald Trump to be our leader. And he's, and you, like you say, is he really following this? But it is prophecy. It is prophesized in the, you know, and it's for myself, once I got to Israel in 2015, I couldn't get enough of it. I went back, got baptized by Jonathan Kahn. I've been over there with Sid Roth, you know, different groups. And every time it's like, it's you say, well, you've seen it once. No.
You've just begun, by the way. I've been there over 50 times. You've got to get back there.
Yeah, just amazing.
I want to go back to something that's really, really keeps, every time I hear your testimony, it just keeps striking me that God had his hand on you, and you knew that he was going to raise this business up as a platform.
Right.
Not to be successful for the sake of success or money, but to serve him, to help drug addicts.
Right.
This is an amazing thing. Talk about some of the things going on.
Right, and it's not just, you know, here's the thing with I knew that God was going to provide this platform, and I knew early on that I would be provided a platform. But for what? It was to help addicts in my head, but in reality, it's to help people get to the Lord. It's an evangelical platform.
Yeah.
And you know, I wore my cross on TV for years, and I wasn't saved yet. I hadn't done a full surrender.
That's amazing.
You know,
to me.
I mean,
why? Why?
I even wore. You know, I even wore it when I'd be in a crack house smoking crack. I just wore it. I wanted to be that person. I guess. If I want to get somewhere, I would sit and tell my friends, you know, about you know, reading the Bibles in jail, like I said before. And I'm trying to convince myself, you know, and it took a lot. I met my gal Kendra in the summer of 2014, and you know, I seen something in her that I didn't have, and I wanted that.
Yeah.
And then miracles started happening to me, things that the odds are just astronomical. I mean, the spring of 15, I had a dream I would be in a room with Donald Trump, and I'm going, what? That's weird, in an office. And a month later, he runs for president. Then I go to Israel. Then I end up at the National National Prayer Breakfast, and I get picked out of 12 people to pray in a room with Ben Carson when he was still running for office. And I'm going, why am I getting picked? I'm just, all these things started to be put into place by God. And we ended up becoming great friends, Ben Carson and I, but also I had a dream of the, you know, meeting the president or meet Donald Trump.
Back in 2015, before he ever ran.
And he reached out to me to meet him, and that meeting came to fruition on August 15, 2016. I meet him for half hour. Then if anyone see me on TV, the first time I'm ever in the White House, I'm sitting next to him. I'm going, who's sitting here? The president is. We're on national TV, and all my ex-crack friends are going, what is this crack addict doing on TV next to the president? He always told us that, you know, Jesus is real, because this is impossible. So this led up to me to February 18, 2017. I went into this like retreat thing. It's called Operation Restore Warrior. Even though I'm not a veteran, These guys told that God told them, you know, we need to bring him in. And I got in there. I went in there with hope, and I came out there with a full surrender, and I'm going. And about 2 months later, I spoke to 50,000 people. Here's a guy that couldn't talk, and let him in prayer.
That's when you completely surrendered your life to the Lord.
Completely surrendered. And it was such a peaceful feeling. It was like, I don't have anything to worry about now. That's on God, you know. That's,
it
was like,
finally it happened.
Yeah, weight lifted off my shoulder of all those, you know, him chasing me, but me also being, you know, I don't know if it was incorrigible. I was, well, you know, here I am. He kept saying, here I am, and I'm going, show me more. You
know? Mike, God so clearly has had his hand on you. What are the odds of it all?
Yeah.
They're too great. It's a miracle.
Yes. Well, it really is. And, you know, I think the, you know, with the story, it's going to give so many people hope. And it's not just about addiction. There's also entrepreneurship in there. But the whole thing of the book is, against all odds, you know, God followed me the whole time, chased me. He was always there for me. He said, here I am, here I am, here I am. But I want to, you know, in the book, what you're going to see, you know, 14 near-death experiences. I mean, these are just, you know, it's like reading a novel, the best fiction novel you ever read, and you go, what a minute, this is true? And then, I mean, there's stuff in the book that I couldn't even put in there because it's so out there that, but everything too that's in there, I have pictures and stuff. I kept stuff. It's like God had me keep stuff all my life that validates that this really happened, that this really happened, that this really happened. But one of the things too, which people, one of my miracles that I see, the last thing I ever thought that I would be talking, that my voice would be, you know, to be out, go out and evangelize for, you know, that was the platform all along to be able to, that would be my calling. Well, here's a kid, when I was a kid, and my parents divorced when I was 7, I'm put into a school where I was the only kid from a broken family, and that manifested into fear of rejection. Do I fit in? And, you know, finally, you know, all these masks, these addictions that come in to mask that pain and give me false courage. But I think it's so common out there, you know, the fatherlessness. And when I quit everything overnight and got freed of the addictions, that was different than when I did a full surrender to Jesus. And people say, I got to be careful there and say, you know, it was a miracle, God. I never had the desire again for the drugs. But 2 months later, I went to a faith-based treatment center at our church. And I thought, you know, it was different. I got in there and they said, we don't care how much you did or whatever. They said, well, tell us about your father. And I'm going, what do you care about my father? I said, he's like, you know, great. I said, I come from a divorced family. But they started going back and finding these wounds that I had. And, you know, I think I believe that stuff that happens in childhood, I believe can manifest to addiction or Jesus.
Mike, your story, you may have different details, mm-hmm. but your story is a story everyone can relate to. We all have to go through life, and there's wounds and pains in life,
right.
And the Lord wants you to have abundant life. He really does. And so this is a book of hope. What are the odds? We want to get it into your hands this week. It's our way of saying thank you for partnering with us, and I really want to invite you, become a Shalom partner. There are Jewish people and neighbors that need clean water, Holocaust survivors that need dental care and food right now during COVID, so you can get involved. Please pick up the phone and call, and we'll get Mike's book right out to you. What are the odds? They're too great. It's a miracle, and he wants to do a miracle in your life.
Jonathan's guest today, Mike Lindell, is proof of God's faithfulness and commitment to restoration. It's a true story of the Lord's redemptive power. What are the odds is Mike Lindell's personal testimony of his journey from being a self-destructive crack addict to now being the CEO of a very successful company in the United States. This book will inspire you and show you the power of the gospel. Mike's autobiography, What Are the Odds, is available today for your one-time gift of $40. And we will include this Stand with Israel keychain as a reminder that your gift is supporting Jewish voice outreaches around the world. Don't miss this opportunity to receive both of these resources as you support Jewish voice ministries with a one-time gift today of $40 or more. Jonathan is encouraging you to join him as a new monthly Shalom partner today. Your continued monthly gifts are vital in providing the ongoing support so desperately needed in these communities. As you make an ongoing commitment and become a new monthly Shalom partner with a gift of just $30 today, you'll not only receive What Are the Odds and the Stand with Israel keychain, but Jonathan will also send you this beautifully woven peace blessing Afghan throw, declaring the words of Psalm 122. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May those who love you be at peace. May there be shalom within your walls. Again, you will receive these resources for your generous support of just $30 a month. Your gift today can change a life, providing the opportunity to not only meet their physical needs, but also the chance to share the love of Jesus in a very real and personal way. Call our 800 number now and let our representative know what level of giving you would like to participate in. If you prefer, you can always choose to give online at jewishvoice.tv, or you can simply text JVMI to 474747. You can also donate by mailing your gift to the address on the screen. If you are already a Shalom partner, please call to receive a special offer just for you. Thank you for your generous support of Jewish Voice and for making a difference in so many lives through your sacrifice. Now, let's rejoin Jonathan and Mike Lindell.
God is watching. He cares. He loves you. And you need to get time in the Word, because no weapon formed against you will prosper. You need to get that into your heart. Mike, I'm going to ask you to just join me in prayer, and we're going to agree together right now. Lord, we thank you that you're a God who is very much alive. It's about a relationship with you, and we pray for people that have no hope, Lord, that you would give them hope right now. We pray for financial needs to be met, for people that need healing to be healed. Lord, for those that have written in saying my family member or friend has COVID, we speak healing to you in the name above every name, the name of Yeshua, Jesus, by whose wounds you are healed.
Yeah, and I'd like to add to that, if there's anyone that you see that has the same wounds I have, which we all have wounds that go, we don't even know where the pain comes from or where it's come from, we ask that you restore their hearts, Lord, and that they, I ask, my prayer is that everyone out there can just get on their knees and surrender to you, Jesus, and that my story will give them hope, and that everyone's story, they all know people out there, anyone out there that has, that they know their hope match, they see, and they see that most of the time, there, all the time, that answer is you, Jesus. And I just pray that everyone out there can just surrender to Jesus, and we're in the biggest revival ever.
Yes, we thank you, Lord. Hey, if you want more information, you can log on to our website. It's jewishvoice.tv. We'd love to hear from you today. We so thank God for you. And thanks to my guest, Mike Lindell, for joining us today. We're out of time, but until next time, I want to remind you, as I always do, to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. The Bible says they shall prosper that love thee. Until next time, this is Jonathan Bernis saying shalom and God bless you.
Don't miss the Jewish Voice Israel Tour. You'll walk the ancient streets where Yeshua walked. You'll learn from Jonathan Bernis as he shares teachings at historic sites throughout Israel. Make new friends, savor some of Israel's most delectable foods, and experience memorable adventures.
This experience will change your life, and you'll never read the Bible the same again.
For more information, call 800-299-9374 or go to jewishvoice.tv/Israel.